PTV receives state arts funding support through a grant from the Pennsylvania Council on the Arts, a state agency. Funded by the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania and the National Endowment for the Arts, a federal agency.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Backstage. I'm your host, David Edgar Guest, and tonight I have a magical show for you. In fact, I'm going to start out with a little magic. I'm going to do this card trick for you folks, and I've done this card trick many times. I've done this card trick all over the floor. Well, it only goes uphill from here and gets a lot better. So, folks, stay tuned and watch. I have some, later on in the program, I have a videotape of Our Town, which is being produced at the Women's Center in Reading, and that will be at the end of the month and into the first weekend of October. But coming up not long after that is a benefit for Children's Dyslexia Centers, and it's going to be a wonderful magic show. And to talk about that magic show, I have with me Wayne Shifflet to my left and Rich Gerber to his left. Welcome, gentlemen.
Thank you. It's great to be here.
Thank you. Now, Wayne, you've been with me before, so
yes.
you were prepared for that bad one. But I do want to reveal a secret of magic. You know when they put swords through the people? Well, what happens is they have the person that gets a sword through them eat so much Swiss cheese that the blade just goes right through the holes and nothing happens. Okay. Now you know what killed vaudeville. Let's see what resurrected it.
Great.
Wayne, you have a magic shop.
Yes.
Tell us a little bit about that.
It's the Mingus Magic Shop. We're located at 528 Lancaster Avenue. Mm-hmm. It was started in 1938 by Leroy Mingus. We've been one of the oldest brick-and-mortar magic shops in the country.
Mm-hmm. Okay. And Rich, you're a magician yourself. Tell us a little bit about you and what you do as a magician.
I perform magic. I do birthday parties. I performed at the Reading Phillies. I'm doing family days at Kutztown University. And pretty much anywhere anybody will watch. And it all started with going to Mingus Magic Shop. I've been going to that shop. I started going there when I was probably about 10 years old, so that was a long time ago. I started doing tricks, kind of like the one you just did.
Probably better, though.
I don't know about that.
We're all good at that.
But yeah, and there's a bunch of us there that, you know, we do birthday parties and mm-hmm. perform for anybody that'll watch. And we also mm-hmm. have our own little magic club that we try to enhance the magic community, and not just the magic community, but the community around us, which is mm-hmm. what brings us together for putting on a show like the one we're doing at the Scottish Rite Cathedral.
Mm-hmm. Now, you were with the Film Fest. You
yes.
had a thing.
Yes.
We're sponsoring one
right.
of those.
There was a documentary done on the Mingus Magic Shop. One of our club members, Ryan Adamovich, did a 45-minute mm-hmm. documentary on the history and the legacy of the Mingus Magic mm-hmm. Shop, being one of the oldest in the country. Mm-hmm. And we were in the Reading Film Festival last year, along with some other film festivals, and that was a lot of fun.
Great. Well, let's find out a little bit about, first of all, the benefit itself. This is for the Freemasonry at the Scottish Rite Cathedral. And tell us a little bit about the benefit itself, what you know of it and all.
The Magic Club's putting on the show, and it is a fundraiser, and one of the main charities the Scottish Rite operates is the Dyslexia Fund for Children. So all the proceeds are going to go to that. It's that's their main thing. We do it also as a kind of a little fundraiser for our club. We're just hoping to get our money back out of it. But mm-hmm. you know, all proceeds will benefit the Children's Dyslexia Center mm-hmm. of Reading. Mm-hmm. It's a wonderful, wonderful cause. And in the past, this is we've been doing the Magic Convention for
45 years plus.
So you guys have been doing. I've been short yes. period of time. And every year we try to pick a pick a charity for the money to go towards. Like I said, mm-hmm. we try to help the community. This year, we're partnering up with the Scottish Rite. They are putting a lot of effort, time, effort, and money into trying to make this a success. And we were lucky enough to bring in Lance Burton, mm-hmm. who is master magician from Las Vegas, if you don't know. He headlined at the Monte Carlo Hotel Resort and Casino. He had his own theater there for probably like 20 years. He's widely considered this generation's best stage magician. For 20 years, he sold out shows in Vegas. So we're hoping with the help of everybody that he can sell out one night in Reading.
Well, I look forward to hearing about it. Unfortunately, I don't believe I'm going to be available at that time, but you folks can get out there on Saturday, October the 19th at 8 p.m. Over there at the Scottish Rite Cathedral in West Reading, right next to the Reading Hospital. And tickets...
Tickets are available at our website, PA Magicfest. Mm-hmm. They're also available at the Scottish Rite office mm-hmm. and at the Mingus Magic Shop.
Mm-hmm. And where is the Mingus Magic Shop located?
528 Lancaster Avenue, thank you for asking. Mm-hmm. tickets are $40 for adults and $25 for children 12 and under.
Mm-hmm. A wonderful cause to support. And on top of supporting this cause to help people with dyslexia to cope with it. I know of a few people who have that, and it really makes it a little more difficult to do different things and to get around and cope with the world we live in. So this is a very fine organization that is doing some very fine work. And having the arts, the magic arts in this particular case, help support it is such a wonderful thing. It shows how the arts and the community can blend together to bring in some wonderful entertainment and a lot of fun. You help not only the community businesses through what they what the theater groups and all have to purchase through the groups, plus the restaurants and all that. You can make a wonderful evening of it. And then you get to see fine people like Wayne and Rich here do their thing, in this particular case, magic.
Yeah. And for those who are interested, in addition to the evening show, it is an actual all-day convention mm-hmm. Where we have vendors and dealers, we have lectures, we have a silent auction, we have close-up show. For those who register early enough, there's a dinner, and then they get the evening show, and that's $125 for the whole day.
Yeah, we're flying. There's a magician by the name of Danny D'Ortiz. He's a Spanish magician, lives in Spain, and we are flying him in. He specializes in close-up magic. He'll be mm-hmm. doing his full 45-minute close-up show during the day. So if you register for an all-day ticket, not only do you get to see magic dealers, a close-up mm-hmm. magic show, Danny D'Ortiz will teach magic. He will actually lecture in magic and teach it. You get a whole big bunch of it. Just it's a lot. Mm-hmm. All that for $125. You get the evening show at dinner, mm-hmm. Close-up show. But it just, you gotta, if you're really into magic, that's the way to go. Or if you know kids that are into magic, or you're into magic, or anybody, it's a wonderful day. Like I say, Danny D'Ortiz is world known, world famous, specializing in close-up magic.
Now, for those who may not understand the difference between close-up magic and long-distance magic?
Stage magic. Stage magic.
Stage magic, okay. What is the real difference between that and how do you get involved in doing either one or both?
Stage magic is like if you go to Las Vegas and they perform up on a stage, mm-hmm. They're the big illusions. Making a tiger appear, shoving the swords through somebody. Anything mm-hmm. that's done up on stage is the big illusions. Close-up magic is more intimate. It would kind of, I guess the hot new term for nowadays is street magic. It's where you get up close and personal. It's only done a few feet away from your face, and it's a very intimate kind of magic, which you know, some people prefer that more to close up. But the stage is the grand illusions, the showgirls, the dancing, and all that big stuff.
Yes, I've heard of a number of different shows that have gone through in which they have a storyline connected to it, but it's all about the magic, and that ties everything together. The story just helps to move the different illusions and all along.
Exactly.
Now, what do you find is most fascinating about the art of magic? Is it the challenge? Is it the learning of how to perform magic?
Well, for me, it's the audience reaction. It's seeing how the kids or the adults react to what you're doing. You're doing something that's totally against the law of science. You're making things vanish. You're making them appear. One solid object going through another solid object. You're defying gravity. And it's just watching the expression on people, their faces to see. That's what I enjoy watching most.
For me, it's the astonishment. Our lives are too bogged down in reality, and too many bad things happen, and we get caught up in our phones and computers, and it's nice when you can do a magic trick for somebody, and you can see it in their face just for 1 second. They're taken back to when they were a kid, and anything's possible. They're just that moment, and you hope that lasts with them, and they enjoy it, and it's all about fun. It goes back. Go back to being a kid when you don't have to take life so seriously, and you can have fun. And he's good at teaching that.
Yeah, it was amazing to see. I've been over to your shop a few times, and it was amazing to watch the people perform the magic, and also to see them learning.
Exactly. And that's what a brick and mortar magic shop is about, for magicians to come in, learn from each other, networking and just performing shows and learning from each other. If they may have a trick they're interested in doing, but they're stuck with a technique or something, and somebody just might happen to know, how to overcome something and learn from that. So it's, and there's quite a few magicians in the area that are working full time, doing a lot of restaurant magic. So there is a lot of magic going on in Reading and Berks County area, which is why it's great to bring Lance Burton.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, there was one from the area, mentalist. I'm trying to think of his name.
Wayne Hoffman,
yes.
Wayne Hoffman,
yeah.
Yes.
Yeah, he's going on, the last I heard, he was doing quite a few shows out in the West.
He was on Penn & Teller Fool Us.
Ah.
Yes, worldwide. Mm-hmm.
He's been on America's Got Talent, Penn and Teller. Yeah. Yeah, Wayne's done it all.
The Ellen Show, yes, he's been on many, many TV shows, yes.
Okay, well, we're going to give you a taste of what's going to happen when you go over to the PA Magic Convention. And we have a video in the back, a little bit from Lance Burton. And if you folks are ready to roll that segment of the tape, we'd like to give the home viewer an opportunity to see some of what may occur when they go to the Scottish Rite Cathedral on Saturday, October the 19th. Thank you. Okay, and that was a little bit about Lance Burton and some of the magic that he performed. That was a lot of fun to watch that and all. I'm going, okay, now how do you do that? How do you know? And it's just such wonderful talent in there to make that happen.
And it's more impressive when you're live in the audience.
Mm-hmm. Yes. Oh my gosh. Without a doubt.
Nothing beats seeing magic live.
Yeah. Oh, I agree with you on that. In fact, this is going to be the closest thing we have to live in the audience for you at this point in time until you get over to the Scottish Rite Cathedral on the 19th of October. Gentlemen, I believe you have a couple of tricks up your sleeves or something like that. And, you know, if you'd show us a little bit of magic here.
We'll try it.
Go right ahead. Go for it.
No doves are going to fly out of this. Mm-hmm. What I can do.
No, I'd have to clean it up.
What I can do is watch.
And the nice part about that is when magicians get together and mm-hmm. perform, we can actually work with each other. So if mm-hmm. you really look right here, mm-hmm. I can actually find mm-hmm. that handkerchief just like that where it was.
Wow.
There we go. But the thing about the clip you just saw, what a lot of people have to realize is that might have been like a, I don't know, a 3 or 4 minute clip, which mm-hmm. literally took hours and hours mm-hmm. and hours to perfect. Mm-hmm. And every move is choreographed. Mm-hmm. And it's amazing the amount of time a lot of magicians put into their art to mm-hmm. make it look just so mm-hmm. natural that it's mm-hmm. it's magic in itself.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. One thing I would like to point out too about mm-hmm. Lance, it's not just Lance Burton. He's going to he's there with friends.
Right.
He has a world class mm-hmm. juggler with him. It's like a variety show. So it's not just an hour long of magic. It's mm-hmm. There's going to be comedy. Michael Gadow, a world class juggler, is fantastic. Fielding West, who's also a comedy magician, but he's fantastic. And
Keith West
is also going to be doing is also going to be doing illusions. So it's a full Vegas style variety show,
family friendly.
Yep,
and showgirls.
There's going to be dancers. He has a mm-hmm. cast of seven people to help him on stage, assistants, dancers. Get your tickets at the Mingus Magic Shop, mm-hmm. which is
at 528 Lancaster Avenue. Mm-hmm. Thank you for asking.
you talk about how it takes a while to perfect this. What goes into working on an illusion, on a trick on this? I guess it's kind of like anything else. You're in a profession or whatever, trade, what have you, and you need to learn and practice and study.
I kind of relate it to playing a musical instrument. You know, if you hear mm-hmm. a song and you want to play it on a piano or a guitar, you're not going to sit down and play it right away. You mm-hmm. got to learn the notes, the keys, the chords, mm-hmm. and it's going to take hours before you can learn how to do it. Then you want to also add your own style and your own personality to the music. Magic is the same way. The first few times you go to do a trick, you're going to mess it up tremendously, many times. In fact, even once we get it down where we think we know what we're doing, mm-hmm. we'll mess it up anyway sometimes. Mm-hmm. The hard part is trying to cover it up mm-hmm. to make sure that the audience mm-hmm. doesn't know you screwed up.
Yeah, because, you know, it's like anything in life. You never know what's going to happen.
Exactly.
And the best planning, the best the best work you do to prepare,
something you can go wrong.
Yeah.
That's the joy of seeing live magic too. You don't know what what's going to happen. Mm-hmm. It's much better than on TV. Mm-hmm.
That's one of the reasons I like doing this program, because I never know what's going to happen here. Fortunately, I don't have any crazy things happen like a dove come down, dive bomb me or whatever or anything like that. But I've done some theater productions, directed them or been in there where something isn't in place or something doesn't go the way it's supposed to go, and you go, okay, how do I get this? I was told by one of my acting coaches a number of years ago that you know, you prepare for anything. If you're learning your lines or doing that, do it while you're doing something else and be aware on that. Because during this one performance of Frankie and Johnny that she had done, taking eggs from the table or the stove and going to put them back into a refrigerator, they dropped on the floor. And, well, you can't just leave them there. You have to cover that up. You have to clean it up and move on. And that's what, you know. Do you have any other examples of magic with you, or besides making me disappear at the end?
Something quick. This is a bit of a close-up. Mm-hmm. Here we have a traffic light on one side, mm-hmm. blank on
Hopefully
both.
Hopefully they can get in there and see that.
And David, if you just hold out your hands, I'm going to give you the traffic light over here.
Okay.
And your other hand.
Okay.
Give you the blank one over here. Mm-hmm. And of course, in a traffic light, red means
stop.
Yellow means
caution.
Green.
Go.
That's exactly what happened to the green one when you said go. It went from there to there. Check them both out.
Wow. Here you go.
And that's part of close-up magic. Happens right in your hand.
Mm-hmm. Right there.
Yes.
And I don't know how that happened. Now I'm going to put them back together. No. Oh, well. Here,
you
work on that and you put them back together. as you say, you need to work to perfect that that talent, to perfect that illusion and all. Now, I guess this really makes a lot of difference for a professional of keeping the trade tight and all. Well, we're coming down to the end of the segment, and I want to thank you both, Wayne and Rich, for being on the program to talk about the Lance Burton show that's coming up for a benefit for Children's Dyslexia Center at and it's going to be Saturday, October the 19th at 8 p.m. At the Scottish Rite Cathedral, the Freemasonry folks, and they're going to put that. They do a wonderful job for everyone.
PAMagicFest.com for information.
Pardon?
PAMagicFest.com for information, or Mingus Magic Shop.
Okay, and I'd recommend going over to the Magic Shop because it is magic.
Exactly. Thank you.
And you're welcome.
Saturday afternoons, there's lots of magicians there that will show you more tricks than you ever want to see.
Okay, we're going to go to a break, and then when we come back, I have a video for you of the upcoming production of Our Town by Thornton Wilder. George Hatza and I will discuss that that show that's coming up. And in the meantime, he's at rehearsal, and I'm going to get to rehearsal. So thank you for joining me and my guests on Backstage, and we'll see you next month Backstage, but stay tuned for the video.
He has been called the greatest stage magician of the past century. And now this legendary entertainer is coming to your town live and in person. And he's bringing his friends for an evening of magic, comedy, juggling, audience interaction, and surprises. Don't miss Lance Burton and Friends Live. Get your tickets now for Lance Burton, Master Magician and Friends. It's fun for the whole family.